back for a return visit, are you?
Keeping it together, Bree. I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much. You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
Yep.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
The boys working are everywhere.
Then don't come over. Not like you're going.
You're here to protect us.
I don't come visiting, Tug.
I. Yes, of course.
How you holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Divine order to march against the ancient empire!
Keeping it together, Bree. I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much. You're safe among friends. Never forget.
Alexander was slain by singers. Culprits still at large.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over.
I don't come visit you, son. Who will?
Would you like to know? Hear ye!
Keeping it together, Bree.
Queen Justinia,
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much. You're safe among friends. Never forget.
Did you find him? Did you find Peepa's papa? Yes! He wandered.
There's paladins up ahead, men of my vintage. Wonder if I served with any of them back in the war.
Who goes there?
Ha! If you're looking for adventure, east's the way to go. It's a void-woken hellhole over there. Sorcerer at work. Powerful one. Of course, you could wait for the magisters to sort them out. You'll be waiting. I dare say you have, adventurer. But I suspect you've seen nothing like what lies beyond, except maybe in your nightmares. Every time the Void Woken come, they're bigger and there's more of them. Still, you want to go east, you go east. We won't stop you.
Careful, I've spotted a trap.
Here be witchery. Trespass not.
Smells of lavender and charred flesh. It's almost homely. Almost. Is that her eye? Did she pluck out her own eye? I need to get clever with this lock.
Oh, my gods, you're ugly. You turn milk green and a magister's red coat black. My mistress Alice might fancy you, though. She has a taste for the odd. If she ever makes it back, the magisters with the red coats chased her into the woods. They'll be sorry.
Did you expect a needle? Did you expect a needle? Did you expect a needle? Did you expect a needle?
What's this? I found something.
Old friend, what have you become? Thank you.
Jonathan, how long has it been?
Gareth looks to the limp body at his feet, then to you, sword raised. He isn't quite present, but lost in his own tangled thoughts.
I knew I'd see him again. I wish it hadn't been like this. Mother and father will have to wait. There's been a distraction.
Gareth softly pokes the listless man's torso with his foot.
This man, this magister, his name is Jonathan. He's my friend, or was my friend. I led him here. I felt someone's gaze on me from almost the very moment I stepped foot on the coast. Lucian taught never to ignore augury. And sure enough, I saw the flash of white. I heard the sprigs snapping. Someone was watching, following. I came here and waited. The door swung open and it was him. A face I hadn't seen since I was called to the Seekers. He didn't say a word, just flashed the arrest warrant. Seems he didn't expect. Now I must do as duty requires.
Gareth raises his blade and tightens his grip, but falters. He cannot strike the final blow. Gareth's fingers open and close around his sword's hilt. His breathing quickens, his forehead wrinkles, yet his arm remains suspended in air. Blood seeps from Jonathan's wound and pools at Gareth's feet. He stares at the stream as it carves a path around his boots.
What? What have you done?
Gareth's eyes go glassy. There is no warmth, no chill, no joy, no sadness. It is as if the void has possessed him.
I need to go. Away from here. Away from this. Away from you. Yes, yes, you're right. There's little time for tears. When it is time to sail, I will be ready.